So the next important class is moderate to low agonist. Examples are codeine, fol-codeine, dextromethorphan and noscapine. So these all agents are mainly used as cough suppressant, or you can say antitussives. They mainly inhibits cough centers present in the brain. Okay. Now next class is partial agonist. Partial agonist, so these are partial agonists for mainly mu receptor. Okay. And we have got an example, buprenorphine. Now the question comes, why do we have developed a partial agonist? I mean, we have strong agonist, so why we require partial agonist? So the answer is, opioids cannot be used for mild to moderate pain because it causes an adverse effect of respiratory depression as a side effect. But a partial agonist, what they will do, they will produce a ceiling effect for respiratory depression. That means a strong agonist will produce, suppose this much, you can say 80% of respiratory depression, that then partial agonist will produce very small, only this much, suppose you can say 40%. So we have got a ceiling effect for respiratory depression with partial agonist. But buprenorphine is not of much use because, like, it has got ceiling effect for respiratory depression, it has got ceiling effect for analgesic action as well. Okay, so partial agonist is mainly developed to so that it produces a less amount of adverse effect as compared to strong agonist. Next class is opioid agonist and antagonist. Okay, so these agents are mainly, you can say, agonist for kappa receptor and antagonist for mu receptor. Okay, example are pentazocine, nalbuphine and butorphanol. Okay, you can remember it by the mnemonic: Punjab National Bank, pentazocine, nalbuphine and butorphanol. Okay, they may mainly causes hallucinations as adverse effect.